Hey everybody, welcome back. We are watching 13 Reasons Why. I don't even know what episode we're on. We are on season 4, episode 8. This is called Acceptance and Rejection. Last time I was getting a little fed up with everything. I don't know how I'm gonna feel about this time. There's somebody that's still provoking, being the antagonist. And it's not the football players because they're getting attacked also. But it's interesting. I've got a smoothie, trying to stay hydrated. Had an incident. I posted an update about it. This is months later. If you see it, this is Wild Berries, I think is what the title of it is. It's frozen fruit. It's strawberries, blackberries, raspberries, and blueberries. And then it's got almond milk and half a cup of yogurt with some mint and paprika, and it's really good. She's gonna look at the bottom of the cup. She likes the water. So if you see me drinking it, that's what it is, homemade smoothie. Let's get to it.
The year is 2161. Earth is an arid landfill, desolate, polluted.
This isn't his essay. Yeah, is this really one of Clay's dreams? It reminds me of Stephen King. Not Blade Runner. Running Man. That's what it reminds me of. So it was a dream.
So you boys heard there was an operation.
I'm gonna confess to everything.
Hey, I hear there's a Ford and Lightfoot concert coming to town, though. What is that?
Ford and Lightfoot? Wasn't he like the 70s?
There was this whole feeling that the bad shit was about to happen.
I wish you the best.
He's always been a doom and gloom kind of fella.
I'm not gonna get better, so.
I can't tell if they're trying to show he's relapsed or not.
It's a real pleasure watching you fight, Tommy. I hope you continue fighting. In the ring rings.
I wonder why he's suspicious of the guy. And he doesn't have responsibilities that would necessarily keep him there. He's just using that as an excuse.
What do you think you're doing?
It's a walkout, sir.
I was trying to think if I've ever had a walkout in my school. I think we had one that was a true walkout. We had senior day where all the seniors skipped. I think we had one walkout. I can't remember for certain. I don't agree with damage to property. Hiding in the principal's office? It's not his office, it's the reception room. And you know, this was filmed months before what's currently going on in the U.S. So, kind of weird. Even though I know
Officer,
it's gone on for years.
Go find him. Go!
He's with you because you're best friends. Even though he wants a little more.
Fire! Everyone! Move!
I wonder whose car that was. I didn't see anything that could light it on fire, so I'm a little curious about that.
And then the police never found out who destroyed the principal's car?
Yeah.
No.
I don't remember. At all.
So he's going into fugue states. Is it fugue? I think it's fugue states.
Then we have a problem here.
I had a feeling it might be him. So that was episode 8. They started off with a weird dream for Clay that reminded me of Running Man. If you haven't seen the movie, it's based on a Stephen King book. It's actually under his pseudonym, which is Richard Bachman. Arnold Schwarzenegger is in it. One of the game show hosts is in it because he plays a game show host. It's one of those guilty pleasure movies. You know, it's not really a top-end movie, but you still watch it. So, I didn't understand the point of the dream. In fact, I didn't actually recognize who it was. I think it was Bryce that was in the dream, but I wasn't sure. I was right about Clay being the one that was doing that stuff, since they were kind of indicating that he was losing track of time in the earlier episodes. I thought that might be a possibility. I think I can actually look it up. I think what they're trying to say that he's doing is called fugue states. Dissociative disorder, and a rare psychiatric disorder characterized by reversible amnesia for personal identity, including the memories, personality, and other identifying characteristics of individuality. The state can last days, months, or longer. That might not be correct then. The fugue is a condition in which the individual wanders away from his home or place of work for periods of hours, days, or even weeks. One celebrated case was that of Reverend Ansel Bourne, described by the U.S. psychologist William James. Amnesia, dissociative disorders. The clergyman wandered away from home for 2 months and acquired a new identity. On his return, he found to have no memory of the period of absence, though it was eventually restored under hypnosis. In not all cases, however, is the basis of the fugue so manifestly psychogenic. Indeed, close observation in some instances may reveal minor alterations in consciousness and behavior that suggest an organic basis, probably epileptic. According to one view, pathological wandering with subsequent amnesia is due to a constellation of factors, among which are a tendency toward periodic depression, history of a broken home in childhood. It's a weird home. How about that? It's not weird. It can be a normal state, but he's acted as if it's weird lately. And a predisposition to states of altered consciousness, even in the absence of an organic brain lesion. Psychoanalysts, on the other hand, see the fugue as a symbolic escape from severe emotional conflict. So I think a fugue state is kind of what they're getting at with him. I don't think he has dissociative identity disorder. I don't think it's that. But it's interesting. We'll leave it at that. I messed up the camera. I don't feel like getting it perfect right now. So fugue state, I think, is what they're going with Clay. I don't think he has dissociative identity disorder. It looks like Diego just figured out that Jessica killed Bryce, which it's been so long now, I can't remember who actually did. I know there were several people that had different motives. I thought Clay killed somebody. But he does have a lot of secrets he's holding, not able to keep them all in. Jess seems to care about both Justin and Diego, but she's not being honest with herself. It's interesting. The thing with can't remember names now. Is it Kyle? The football player, Asian football player. can't remember his name now. At any rate, him and Alex, who's his best friend, them destroying the property and that sideline, I didn't quite understand it all. If they were trying to get at something, it went over my head, other than the fact that Alex cares for him a lot. With the protest, the walkout, and standing there, that was all fine. They lost their moment of penetrating their cause, for a lack of a better way of putting it, as soon as they started attacking, becoming violent. Now that will be used against them. Them arresting Diego instead of Justin, you know, it's there to show the racial injustice, because Justin was the one who started the fight. He shoved Diego first, and the cop did nothing about Justin. Even when Justin went to attack him, he still didn't do anything, but he still handcuffed Diego. Of course, I know the charges were dropped and everything, but that's not the point. The point is, rather than investigating or arresting both of them or, you know, any of that, they just went straight for Diego. I think that's the most of it. I did not agree when they started becoming violent towards the sheriff's department. That just ruined everything for them. So the stand that they were trying to make is null and void now. If they had just remained peaceful with their protest, they might have gotten more accomplished. So, I don't know. That's my thoughts on that. Hopefully, when I edit this, you won't see the parts where my eyes were crossing. So that's why I started braiding the hair, and I've been picking up my nails. It's to stay awake. But my eyes were literally crossing. So I was like, all right, let's get out of here. Thanks for joining me. We'll see what the next episode is about and kind of go from there. I hope everybody has a good day, a good night. Stay safe, wear your masks, and see you soon. Bye.